The John LeBanks Show has been known to make people laugh, sing, think, scream, throw things in rage, and generally lose their minds. Listener discretion is advised.
And I've got to deal with a bad case of sore loserism, I guess. We've got to now listen to Hillary Clinton again. We thought we were rid of her, but apparently not. She is now challenging the results in three states, Michigan, Pennsylvania, and Wisconsin. Hey, right after Jill Stein was going to challenge it as well. And it's interesting because didn't she concede? Didn't she already say she lost the election? I quit. Sorry to all my folks. I mean, she said it late. Go home, everybody. I don't want to say it now. And then later on, it's like, oh, we lost. Doesn't count, I guess, in Hillary's world. Hillary's a person that doesn't mind screwing up and then just say, hey, you know, can I have a do-over? Can I have a do-over? What difference does it make anyways, right? Now she's, you know, after she concedes the election, after she congratulates Donald Trump and tells everybody to, it's time to move on, it's time for us to all get along real well, she doesn't do it. She's like, you know, she cried for 3 weeks, or I mean 2 weeks, or however long she's been crying for her, and then somebody got in her brain and said, you know what, instead of these riots, which they're not working, Hillary, and we're not going to change the electoral votes, we've got to go to Plan C, and Plan C is to literally challenge the election results in any state that she possibly can challenge it. So now we have to deal with that. You know, we thought we were over. We're all planning on dealing with Donald Trump for the next 4 years. The news has been covering him. They give him a special. You're going to screw up the news because they give him a special? I mean, come on. Hillary, again, only thinking of herself. What do you think this is going to do to the country, Hillary, if you somehow successfully challenge in these three states? And it's not like votes are going to go your way. It's going to be like you're taking away votes, right? You're going to try to determine certain votes weren't being able to, you couldn't count those votes. They were ineligible. I mean, how are you going to mysteriously, whatever the word is, come up with more votes for you? I'm just wondering. The votes are the votes. Be nice if we could get rid of California, because if we get rid of California, you haven't even a challenge. Why even challenge? Jill Stein started this. Again, I spoke about it in the last hour. How now everything nice I said about Jill Stein is out the window, because come to find out she's a scumbag like everybody else. You know, we should know better. We should know that the people who run for office are scumbags. Every single one of them. It's just the level of scumbaggery you want to deal with. And now we have Hillary, who conceded the election. She said, I lost. I concede the election. Now she's having sour grapes. The riots didn't work. The threatening of the Electoral College didn't work. The petitions on whitehouse.gov didn't work. So now she's got to come out of hiding. She's got to wipe those tears off, put the makeup on, make herself look healthy again, because she's probably, you know, although she probably had a mini stroke while she was gone. She was completely out of the spotlight. We didn't hear a damn thing about her. No speeches. That last little speech, and that was it. She was gone. She went into hiding. Why wouldn't you? If you lost this big of an election, when you thought you were going to win, when you thought you had it rigged for you to win. Just too many people countered that rigging. All those dead people. I wonder how many dead people voted for Hillary. Bet you more dead than Trump. We'll find that out, I'm sure, some years down the road when they calculate who was alive and who was dead at that moment when the election happened. Apparently all the early voting was in Trump's favor. Hillary, you canceled your fireworks. You knew. You knew you were going to lose. You canceled them already. And you were drinking. You must have been watching us on YouTube there. We were having the drinking game, and maybe you were having the drinking game with us. But the sour grapes is now being crushed into wine. And now we have to hear about recounts for who knows how long. Who knows how long. And if that doesn't work, maybe they're going to challenge it and go to the Supreme Court and see how that works out. Any way possible. Any way possible to make the election results turn out in Hillary's favor. And that's what they care about. Whatever turns out in Hillary's favor. Whatever turns out into the left's favor. They don't care that a particular segment of the population who has been discounted for maybe 16 years, but at least the past eight, finally won something. Finally got a champion, be it a, you know, not a good champion. But hey, the little man, the working man, the guy not bound to a union, the hard-working lady not bound to any political structure, not a feminist. You know, the person who was out there working hard these past 8 to 16, maybe even 24 years, maybe even a little longer, and watch their work stay steady or get more, and their incomes decline and get worse. They finally picked a champion, someone they could relate to. And they got him elected. They came out in droves for him. You think it was the establishment Republicans that voted for Donald Trump? Nah, it wasn't them. It was the little guy. The guy who was so sick of the government, sick and tired of the government doing whatever it wanted. Whatever it wanted. And the little guy just had to pay the bill. And the little guy just had to, you know, work harder to survive. Because the taxes that were taken out to, you know, do whatever with, fund whatever project, whatever pet project, maybe some bridge to nowhere. Maybe some foreign government. He was sick of it. And although Donald Trump wasn't the perfect candidate for them, they had a better candidate with Ron Paul, but they weren't as sick of it then. It took 8 years of Obama to push him over the edge. Many of these guys would have much rather had Ron Paul over Donald Trump. But Donald Trump, he hit a nerve, and he had the money, something Ron Paul didn't have. And Trump went out and did it at $5 a head. $5 a head. Not too bad. I mean, it's not too bad, folks, if you think about it. And here's Hillary Clinton. She's going to challenge it. She's going to try to change three states. 10,000, 11,000 votes here in Michigan. She's either got to find that many plus one vote, or she's got to get rid of votes, make them not count. Which way do you think is going to happen? Which do you think is the easier route? They're going to declare a bunch of votes not worthy for whatever reason. That's what they're going to do. They can't mysteriously make new ballots up and add them to the mix. That would make it too suspicious. So they're going to try to get rid of people's votes. Chop out little ones that, this one doesn't count. This one doesn't count. This one doesn't count. That's what they're going to do. How are they going to come up with new ballots? Are they saying that things were, people who voted for Hillary voted for Trump? That, well, if they did, we got to find that out. And that's not up to Hillary to challenge. That's up to you, the voter, to challenge. Go in there and find out what your vote was tallied as. How is your vote counted? Do you know? You know you voted, but do you know how it was counted? Did it go to the candidates you chose? Or was it hacked or rigged? I can't tell you. That's up to you. It's not up to Hillary Clinton. She said she would accept the results. Remember when she was crying during the debates? And in ads, and in rallies. Oh, Donald Trump says he might not accept the results because everything's rigged. And you were making fun of him, Hillary. But now, even after you conceded, you said you lost. You agreed you lost. That's what conceded means. That you said, okay, I lost. I see the results. We don't got it. Sorry. We don't have the number of votes needed in each state. We don't have enough states, that is, to win. Then we got the people talking about, we got to get rid of the Electoral College because it's outdated. Mm-mm. It protects the little state. That's what it does. It's brilliant. It is so brilliant that if you can't understand that concept, you probably just, you don't probably have a high IQ. I'm just telling you that. It protects the little state. The Electoral College always protects the minority. And I'm not talking the minority, whether it's gender or race or any of that. In fact, there's no such thing as that in my terms, in my world. There are almost twice as many women on the planet as men. How can women be a minority? You know who pointed that out? My female boss. Not me. She's smart enough to know that. A minority means the smaller amount. That's why we're a republic and not a democracy. And I'm sick and tired of people talking about how we need to protect our democracy. We're not a democracy. We're a republic, and a republic protects. At least our constitutional republic protects the minority. And again, if you're confusing the word minority with some race or some gender, that's because you've been brainwashed. That's not what minority is meant to mean. It is meant to mean the individual, mainly. The small state. The small group of people. That's what the minority is supposed to mean. It's not supposed to be about race or gender, sexual orientation, none of that. It's about the individual. Race shouldn't matter, as long as the individual is protected. Gender shouldn't matter, as long as the individual is protected. Sexual orientation shouldn't even be brought into the mix. I have people commenting on my videos. Oh, what a great video. I even liked it and I was gay. Why do I need to know that? I don't need to know that. Joe Bob doesn't need to know that. Tina Turner doesn't need to know that. Nobody needs to know that. You want to be gay? That's fine. That's a bedroom private activity. Keep it to yourself, man. That's all. So the minority is not going to be protected if Hillary Clinton finds a way to shift the election, to shuffle some votes, to eliminate some votes, because I don't see how you're going to add votes to the coffers, ladies and gentlemen. The only way for these states to change colors is to discount a vast number of votes. And those people, well, if they're discounted, they're discounted because they voted for Trump. Gotta take a break, folks. More on the flip side.